各位晚安，欢迎起来 Focus 全球新闻。自从北京二十大、中共二十大召开之后，新闻焦点呢都环绕在当习近平在二十大之后进入第三届的任期，他对于所谓的处理台湾问题有没有时间表？今天头条要看的是美国国务卿布林肯星期一在 Stanford 大学的论坛上公开说，在习近平统治下的中国对于长期建立的台海和平现状越来越不耐烦，因此习政权有意加速统一时间表。而面对共军有可能为了达成统一的目标不择手段，那么台海和平如果受到破坏，对于全球供应链以及晶片生产都会带来巨大的打击。布林肯的说法是，全球经济发展和全球人民都会受害。所以布林肯在这个论坛上公开呼吁，全球必须共同努力维护台海和平，也喊话北京回到和平解决分歧的路线上。
从美国众议院议长佩洛西访台之后，解放军在台海持续增加的行动，
绝不承诺放弃使用武力。
到中共领导人习近平在二十大报告中的强硬表态，再再显示北京对台海议题的态度已经出现转变。
Instead of sticking with the status quo that was established in a positive way, a fundamental decision that the status quo was no longer acceptable, and that Beijing was determined to pursue reunification on a much faster timeline.
美国国务卿布林肯周一出席史丹佛大学的论坛，被问到台海局势时，布林肯直指北京当局为了达成统一，不惜破坏台海和平现状。
If peaceful means didn't work, then it would employ coercive means, and possibly, if coercive means don't work, maybe forceful means.To achieve its objectives. And that is what is profoundly disrupting the status quo and creating tremendous tensions.
布林肯更以全球供应链早前因为疫情出状况，导致民生物资甚至工厂制造都出现短缺，所有人都遭殃为例，进一步指出台海和平如果受到侵害，对全世界都不利。
The amount of commercial traffic that goes through the Straits every single day and that has an impact on economies around the world is enormous.If that were to be disrupted as a result of a crisis, countries around the world would suffer.
供应链之外，晶片更是关键。在当前不论是电动车、AI 或是手机，所有产品都仰赖晶片运算的情况下，台海有事就是全球有事。
On semiconductors, if Taiwanese production were disrupted as a result of a crisis, you would have an economic crisis around the world.
同样对北京当局野心高分贝呼吁提高危机意识的还有英国。
Let's be honest, China is an enemy.
英国国防部周二公开示警，指北京当局以高达$27万，约866万元台币的巨额年薪，招募英国与其他西方国家的退役飞官到中国训练解放军，以便对英美等西方军队的最新战术、作战方式和战斗能力有更深层的了解。
We have got British subjects.Who have decided that their interests are best served by teaching our enemy how to defeat us? This is incredibly frightening.
为了隐藏真实讯息，中方往往透过像南非的飞行学院等看似无关的白手套进行招募。至今已经有约30名退役英国飞官曾经或者目前仍继续为解放军效力。
The Ministry of Defense said that we are taking decisive steps to stop Chinese recruitment schemes attempting to headhunt serving and former UK Armed Forces pilots to train the People's Liberation Army personnel in the People's Republic of China.
据了解，这些退役飞官通常比较年长，而且没有驾驶 F-35 等最新战机的经验。尽管退役飞官担任外国训练员并不违反英国法律，但是英国军方正尝试阻止漏洞继续扩大。
Ich sage es hier ganz deutlich: einseitige wirtschaftliche Abhängigkeit macht uns politisch erpressbar.
连向来与北京保持友好的德国，都因为乌俄战争中难以摆脱对俄罗斯能源依赖的教训，转而对北京提高警觉。不但德国外长公开表明要谨慎处理与中国的关系，避免重蹈覆辙，德国联邦情报局局长卡尔更公开呼吁，不要对中国抱持天真的想法，必须重视专制中国对全球带来的威胁，而首当其冲的自然就是台海。
Military conflict between China and Taiwan is not very likely.In the coming 5 years. However, the possibilities will increase dramatically in the fourth five-year term of Xi Jinping.
为了避免台海和平受到破坏，美国呼吁包括中国在内的各方共同努力，并且重新回到和平解决分歧的道路上来。
I hope that Beijing will come back to a place where it actually sees the merits in making sure that differences are peacefully resolved. We remain fundamentally committed to the One China policy as well. That hasn't changed. That won't change. But at the heart of that was a commitment to resolve these differences peacefully.
毕竟要有一个和平的台海，才能对全球经济带来更多繁荣。TVBS 新闻综合报道。